Is my email account private? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question that I got, and honestly, it is very representative of many questions I've gotten over the years. I have a POP3 email address. It belongs to my boyfriend. Is it possible for him as administrator to receive all copies of my incoming and outgoing mail? And if so, how do I detect whether he is doing so? Incidentally, I used another account to ask you this question just in case. The very short answer here is that yes, absolutely. If somebody else is administering your email account, then by definition, they can see everything. They can see everything you send. They can see everything you receive. They have full access. Now, whether or not they're actually doing anything with that access, I can't tell you. That depends on, well, them. But it is very, very important to understand that when you are handing off that ability to someone else helping you out with email or pretty much anything, you're basically giving them a tremendous amount of control or at least access over your information in the future. Now, I get it. It is very often the right thing to do. I consider myself kind of trustworthy, I guess. And as a result, I actually administer email accounts for several friends and family members and others. And yeah, I often joke that if I were to go evil, I could cause a lot of trouble. I don't plan to go evil. But the bottom line is that yes, somebody could. Now, so what is the thing you should be doing if you are concerned? Remember, if you don't trust the person that either will be setting up your email account or other accounts or already has set up those accounts, that's a bad sign. You need to step away from that and basically take control of your own situation. When it comes to email, that means very simply take it on yourself to set up your own email account at another service that you control completely. Something that only you have access to. Yep, that might mean learning how to do it. And that's kind of the trade-off here, right? You've handed off that responsibility to someone else because you didn't want to deal with it. On the other hand, the trade-off is that you've given away some of your privacy. In order to take that back, you need to take the steps to get familiar with and understand what it means to set up an email account of your own under your control. Now, make sure to set up all the recovery information, add two-factor authentication, do the things you need to do to keep that account secure and secure from potential hacking in the future so that you could recover it should anything ever happen. But that is really the other bottom line here is you need to do it yourself. Now, this problem is actually slightly larger than just the individual you might have had set up your account for you. The issue is that email and specifically, but other services as well, you're kind of trusting the service. By that I mean that, yes, when you set up an email account, the service, the employees of that service, in theory, could also see everything that's going on with your account. Do they? I certainly don't believe so. Certainly not if you're picking one of the larger or more trustworthy services. A, they don't have time, and B, as I've said for years, you and I were just not that interesting. But the bottom line here is that that is another level of exposure that you need to at least understand depending on your personal situation. Now, the only real solution, if you are one of the people for whom this is a true issue, the only real solution, encryption. Encryption in email is complicated. It can get really hard. I've got articles on it. There are two approaches that I would recommend. Again, if you find yourself in a situation where you truly are concerned about the email provider or potentially government forcing the email provider to examine your emails, the only thing you can do is encrypt. There are two approaches I would take. One, the simple one, don't write your information in the email itself, but instead, write it in a document that you then encrypt and attach to an email that you send to your recipient. That way, email encryption isn't really involved. You're sending an encrypted attachment, and it's up to you to make sure that your recipient knows the password or has the technology to decrypt that content and be able to see it. But nobody in between can see it. The other approach, and this is actually kind of an opportunity if you really are considering changing your email provider, is to switch to an email provider that does privacy and encryption natively. There are two. Personally, I use Proton Mail. Proton Mail has several different approaches to encryption that can work both between Proton Mail users and between you as a Proton Mail user and somebody who doesn't use Proton Mail. It actually turns out to be fairly straightforward. The other solution that I have heard of is a service called Tutanota. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly, but the bottom line is they too are very privacy and encryption focused. If you are in the process of selecting a new email provider, then both of these services, as I understand it, have free alternatives that may be a better choice for you. But the bottom line here is whenever somebody else has access to your account, be it your boyfriend who set it up, your spouse who's maintaining it, your service provider who runs it, they all have a level of access that you at least need to be aware of. Whether or not they're doing something with it, I can't say. And the only way to protect yourself is to take control yourself. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2275. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.